Good morning, everyone. My name is Paul Tucker. I'm the district attorney for Essex County. I'm here with Chief Keith from the Andover Police Department. Also here with members of the State Police Detective Unit attached to my office at Essex County and members of the Andover Police Department and the Andover Detective Division as well. We're here at this address where Andover Police was summoned this morning. We can get into some of the details. I'm first going to ask Chief Keith to offer a timeline of events that have brought us to this point, and then I'll add a little bit afterwards. Chief?
Thanks, sir. Good morning. Just after 3:21 a.m., Andover Police received a 911 call. Officers arrived on scene roughly 5 minutes after the call. They had to breach two doors to get into the house. When they went inside the house, they found the father, mother, and a 12-year-old son dead. Wounds were from a gunshot. The father was 56 years old. The mother was 55. Again, obviously, it was still under investigation. Obviously, we know the how. We're trying to figure out the why right now. So we're going to need some time to figure that out as we move forward.
Thank you, Chief. As you can imagine, this being only in the first of several hours into this scene, we have quite a bit of work to do. We're still in the preliminary stages. But one of the messages that we would like to make sure that people know is there is no at all. This entire situation was contained within the address here. I think this is also a very good time to remind folks that if they're suffering from any type of mental health issues, any type of depression, that services are out there, whether through service providers. Our office certainly is a community resource for anybody that's having any difficulties as all. I also want to make sure that we recognize the first responders here, the difficulties of working these scenes. We only need to look back at the last couple of weeks in Massachusetts, some of the difficult things that our first responders, our state police detectives, local police officers, firefighters, and EMS, these can take an emotional toll as well. We're always concerned about their well-being. These men and women do an extraordinary job under some very difficult circumstances. We also want to make sure that folks know that there are resources out there. As Chief Keefe said, we will update you as we get more information as appropriate. We're in the stages right now of making notifications to next of kin. I appreciate everybody's presence here this morning helping us to get the word out there. There is no danger at all to anybody in the public. Thank you.
And District Attorney, did the 911 phone call come from inside the house?
Chief?
Yes.
Do we know who made that call? Or are we sharing who made that call?
We are not sharing that yet.
Was there anyone else inside the house other than the mother, father, and son?
No.
No.
Is the school where this child attended, are they going to have counselors on hand? Do you know any of that?
Andover PD did an excellent job putting out notifications this morning. They spoke to the child's school. It's my understanding that school has been canceled, and they're working diligently on their end to do everything they can as well.
The whole school building has canceled?
That's our understanding.
Which school?
St. John's.
And what grade was he in? Do we know?
Sixth grade.
Do you know who the person that did the shooting was?
We're not commenting on anything to do with the investigation at this point, beyond what we've given out this morning.
Have police been called to this home before?
No.
Never. Okay, thank you, everyone.
Okay, thanks, everyone. Appreciate it.
Thank you.